Hello and welcome. I am Arumba. Thank you for joining me. Let's play some more Hearts of Iron 4 as Great Britain. Alright, so I noticed down here on this border, it looks like the Italians have pulled back their divisions. So by all means, we should be pressing forward. There should have been an attack plan in order, just so they could have their preparation bonus, but it's already still at 44%. Let's go ahead and have him engage at high aggression. And this army here, I'm considering moving on Genoa, which is worth 10 victory points, because they are at 77% towards capitulation. It controls 33% of victory points and will capitulate when it has 15% or less. Now, there's a lot of provinces over here that I think still count. The little dots represent, apparently, locations that are usually worth more than one. That one's worth that. We took Paris, which is worth quite a bit. One thing I definitely do want to do is I want to get Cairo back. Because we want to be able to pass through this strait so that we can work on Japan here soon. So I think what we'll do is, if at all possible, if we could find... Maybe after these guys are done, we will send them back down into Africa. United Kingdom. We seem to be doing fine down here. Apparently, there are troops down here protecting whatever's going on down there. So that's good. So anyway, you act on your plan. Let's see if you can march there. This whole little strip might get cut off. And yeah, I'm thinking that this aggressively executing battle plans, units will attack provinces if they're a part of a plan, even if it may mean the front line becomes longer and war may put units in exposed locations. So they're very aggressive. But to the point where they like don't even care if there's a front line or not. They're just, whatever, just attack. Which is good. It's good. It's what I like. It's what I want. I updated the resistance thing so that we are covering the new regions that are causing resistance. And one thing I think I want to do is I queued up some more cavalry brigades, and we're going to go kind of really crazy on cavalry brigades because these guys are cheap. They only cost 600 infantry equipment, and if I'm not mistaken, the manpower requirement's pretty low. And I think what I want to do is I want to get to the point where we can raise our occupation policy here. What we would lose is resistance growth would go up, but we would get more local resources, we would get less local manpower, but we would get more factories. So I kind of want the factories. The manpower situation is actually kind of okay right now. A million is not a huge amount, but hey, we got quite a few troops here, by the way. Let's come in from this direction. Hopefully we can pin him down. One division attacking 92. They're encircled, they have a train and an entrenchment multiplier, but they have low supply. All we gotta do is throw a few more units at this. We should be able to kill. Now it's curious that now we can't tell how many divisions there were. We knew that there were 10 a second ago. What happened to our intel? Riddle me this. 108 combat width worth of divisions here. Hold that attack. And of course we're also attacking Hungary now. Got a guy who's rebasing. Quite a few people who are rebasing, in fact, because looks like I pulled back the front line here because the Soviet Union controls some of the territory. Let's go ahead and move this attack vector. And why don't we have one of these Matildas move in this way? Sorry, I keep calling them Matildas, they're Crusaders. Please don't cut off my supply, by the way. Of course, we have access to a port here, so we should have supplies anyway. These poor guys have very little organization. Looks like we are going to make it there before he can actually get there, so that's good. Genoa's going to be worth a fair bit. How goes this battle now? 99 versus 92. Our breakthrough is pretty good relative to their defense. Our soft attack is quite good. I think we do want some more artillery. Another thing that I did do that I had forgotten to do was upgrade my artillery production to improved artillery. Oops. Never a good thing when you research it, but then you forget to actually use it. Fall of Warsaw. Poland did not stand a chance. Yeah. Okay, so the plan here, I think, is that the Soviet Union's going to conquer all of Poland, and then at some point we're going to, like, return them Or just ignore them and conquer... Conquer, what's his face on our own? Our front line is just miserable with this little section in here that's causing it to be not a contiguous front line. Just rather frustrating. There's still some holdout German Reich settlement type stuff here. I want to kill these Italians right here. I don't want them to have a chance to respawn or like get strong again. I think we do try to attack this, whatever this is. This is only 32 combat width worth of infantry mostly. Can you see more about like what exactly the composition is? You can see there's some of their stats. And we can tell that it's cavalry. They call it a cavalry reserve. That doesn't necessarily mean that it is pure cav. I don't know. Engineering Company 2 is great because it automatically applies to everyone that's using it. Field Hospital, definitely something we want. 122 versus 128. We've got 4 in reserves. Alright, let's just assume that this guy is maybe the one that's not involved in the fight. Like, who are the reserves? Which ones are the reserves? 2 infantry something. I'm trying to widen the combat width here, since we've got clear advantage in numbers. Well, it's not true. They've got more numbers than we do. How are we doing on air superiority in this region? Seem to be doing fine. How much closer is Italy? 85% towards capitulation. We've met resistance. You just march directly to Florence. A little bit of manual control here and there. And you know what? Milan. It's worth 15 points. We're not allowed to retreat here. I don't want you to retreat here. I want you to attack here. You cannot give orders while retreating. Oh, we're instantly overrun. What? Great. How did that happen? Huge bonuses to radar. Is it war with the German Reich? Poland is not in a faction. Wow, that one would have been good when we were doing all the research on science and stuff. And radar. Well, we're returning territory to the French. Which may or may not be considered a good thing. How on earth could we currently be losing here? What's up with this? Oh, we're attacking into the Maginot Line. Forget that. Fort level 10, fort level 0. Fort level 0. Move to here. I think we attack into this province. Surround him, at least get rid of some of that fort bonus. Alright, so, we lack quite a few infantry equipment, but we're only down by 135 days. I did queue up some new light tank production. We've got enough medium tanks, and now we have the manpower for 12 more of our infantry in the primary lines to get upgraded. So let's grab those. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Upgraded to Infantry 2.0. Okay, everything's good. Infantry equipment's shortage, that's fine. We'll sub in those medium tanks, which should provide them with quite a bit more strength. Move on tours. There is no port there. I feel like if we just attack, and this is an infantry 2.0 situation. Look at that, soft attack. Could use some more breakthrough. The train penalty is disadvantageous, but it's okay. Is this land counting? Doesn't seem like this land is actually helping out much. Of course, we also gave back Genoa. We got this one dude, this one crusader guy who's encircled. So if we did clear that out, let's take all this land if we can. These are not of any importance to us. If we can kill this, six divisions here. Pulled out of Italian divisions. Modified government again, we got 150 political points. I think another high command would be good. Division recovery rate. Army logistics. I think I'll take him. Every time, I feel like we're always running low on equipment and manpower, so anything we can do to kind of prevent some of that would be good. You should not be attacking into this fort. You have, look at these values. Why are you doing this? Stop that. If anything, you should move around and try to take this province. Just let them hang out in the damn Maginot line. Suppression is still continuing to be an issue. So we grab you, and you know what? Let's create a new theater. And I'm thinking about actually having multiple armies in this theater. He doesn't really need to even have a leader, honestly. So we have enough, like, we have those provinces covered. They're just not actually, there's not enough units to garrison them. We don't have enough infantry equipment to drop these off. We're trying to make some infantry 2.0s, but they're not trained yet. And you're going nuts. Trying to get back the French territory. Head for the port, because the port would be nice to have. From here, I think he could probably take him. 295 versus 47 soft attack. You've got a lot more defense than we do, but no, we got an advantage here. I think the Italians have run low on manpower at some point. Seems like it, certainly feels like it. However, we can't seem to press down into this province. And these Russians are annoyingly coming in from a strong angle here. They're taking a lot of Hungary over. Oh well, we'll fight the Russians when it's time to fight the Russians. Got lots of army experience. Is there anything we can do to update our template? You know what I would like is anti-tank support. Wish we could research that. Get those being produced. Beyond that, we're already at 22 combat width. Set to high priority. We could. Let's just see, out of curiosity, if I were to drop, this is maybe crazy, but if we were to remove three of the infantry and replace it with two artillery, how do our stats change? We lose 73.8 HP. The manpower cost goes down because we're using more artillery, so that's good. More equipment. Heart attack comes down slightly. Defense goes down by a bit, so we're not as good on defense, but our breakthrough goes up by 0.1. And soft attack goes up by 82. We might want to do this, maybe not on all of them, but on some of them. Just so that we can have, you know, some more breakthrough style type units. So let's reset and duplicate, and then we'll call this, we'll call it by what it is. It's going to end up being, 4 INF plus 4 art plus 1 MT. Check combat width, it should still be 22. 4, 4, and 1. Yep, sounds good. Change the division symbol. Be nice if there was just one that, like, you know, represented artillery. It's not really artillery, though. Ah, here we go. That'll work. So for 15 points, now we can do that. Now, if we actually end up with too much towed artillery, we do have some. These guys take... artillery 168 versus artillery 96. So about 70 extra artillery, so we could replace maybe six of them. Six of the 1.0s in that group. Of course, they can't be from another nation. They've got to be our units. And it looks like we're actually running low on our own units, come to think of it. And I can't upgrade those divisions, so... Tell you what we could do then is, we could just upgrade some of these ones as well. Let's upgrade four of them. That'll conserve some manpower for us. Let's create some more battle plans. That is not at all what I want you to do. So there's 8 divisions assigned to this. Let's shift click, engage that plan aggressively. You should be fighting him. You should be heading over to here. Help out. Don't attack across the river. Got lots of troops relocating. You just got forced to retreat. A little bit of organizational issues. Troops are going kind of crazy. You shouldn't be attacking there. You're supposed to be attacking this guy because there's no fort here. It is mountainous, but we want to encircle this. The cav are having a hard time getting produced. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and we're going to bump up the... let's see. Let's just see how immediate the effect is. We have 244 factories. If I change my policy on the German factories, 244... How quickly does this change? 244, wow. So, from 119... So we gain 13 factories just by doing this. That's pretty substantial. Yeah, and the thing is, we're limited by manpower, by equipment, not by manpower. So I think I'm gonna actually... We're gonna go crazy. On this one. 320 now. Now we have bonus factories available, insufficient resources. And we have free military factories. So where's our greatest shortage? Infantry equipment, 132 days of that. Light tanks, we don't care about too much anymore because we're switching over to the mediums. Let's get some infantry equipment queued up. Pop those to the top. Our front line is spread so thin right now because it's so wide. What are these guys? They're unassigned. Go join this. We have other units that are unassigned. We do. Join that group. I really want to clear out some of this nonsense. 120 versus 108. Our numbers don't look very good. It's nighttime right now. That's a big part of it. We've got a better general than they do. We've got air superiority attacking from multiple angles. We've got a lot of good things going for us. Take this out. Combat's kind of slow, as ever. We still have free military factories, 3 more. I have a feeling we're going to need more artillery, so let's get some more artillery going. Missing equipment production, the carrier fighter, don't care about that. Resistance occupation is going to get pretty high, I think, since we are... Yeah, down here it looks bad. You guys need to execute cautiously. I'm tired of you actually trying to push forward on your own. Although I do want you to try to rescue that Crusader tank. And they're already pushing for Genoa again, which is good. If we can get Milan... It's the Italian cores that we need. Italian core provinces, that's what's important. Okay, so you're on low supplies. Why don't you just assist with this fight? Get yourself back to connected. We're holding this line kind of okay. It's pretty thin. I really need, like, just one dude. Just please, just one dude. To come over here and take back this territory that's owned by the Germans. Do we have, like, a motorized somewhere in here? Here, you. Okay, and then this is part of the Maginot Line. We're being attacked, but we're defending, we're safe. We're trying to push into this province right here, which has no fort. We get these encirclement bonus against him. And now we have exiled divisions. Damn you, Russia. Can't march that way? It's kind of weird. Still, if I get to Budapest, I'll be able to get him to capitulate. Looks like we finally won that fight. I'm gonna send more troops over to this line. Tell them to go that way. Now that we've got these guys on the run, I feel like our organization should allow us to push forward. And the amount, just the sheer volume of military factories we have now is crazy. Also, crap. Somebody had mentioned that we have a surplus of goods and we are importing some. We have a surplus of aluminum and we're importing 64. We don't need to be importing. Let's cancel that. Import. Okay. That'll free up civilian factories. Let's see. More... We have a lot of fighters available. But air superiority seems like it's been... pretty simple, for the most part. Let's deploy some planes. Also, evidently, we've got too many planes in this region. Control click to go to airbase. Let's grab, these guys. Just rebase to here. And then over here, we're gonna create a new 100 fighter unit. And we'll create another new 100 fighter unit. Once they've arrived, we'll get them going. You'll go to southern France. And you'll go to... apparently you can't reach the Alpine region. Let's just wait a moment. So how's this guy looking? He's at 99% fighting strength. He's a pretty good offensive unit because he's got the extra cav. Here, no. Crusaders, stay here. Crusaders, stay here. Engage that army. Come in with the heavy artillery force. Come on, man. Reinforce. 413 soft attack. That's pretty good. You are aggressing against me here. That seems kind of foolish. So we got our buddy back. That being France. This guy is still having a real hard time getting himself free. Alright, quick. Move in here and give him a connection so we can get the supplies in. He is out of supplies. 17.3% attrition. And again, look at these free military factories. Now I'm wondering, like, are we going crazy on resistance? Probably. Resistance strength 72%. We have no more cav that can be deployed. So, let's temporarily bring it back a little bit. We need to get more cav in this region. I don't know if manually moving them there is going to keep them there or not. Probably not, if I had to guess. Expeditionary forces from France. Sure, we'll accept your divisions. What's up with all this attrition? Bad supply? Okay. We do need to be the first one to get to Budapest. We're winning on all three of these. We don't have air support here. Let's take these guys. Move them over to this field. We have 200 fighters here on air superiority. We got 254. Look at that. Somebody's actually trying to contest our air superiority. So we'll go up to 400 planes, which once they arrive, we should have air superiority, giving us another advantage. And a call to arms from Poland. It's funny. Very funny. Poland. Alright, you are well supplied now. Oh, let's see if we can march this, this Crusader army. With the medium tanks on a Milan. And we got isolated. Unfortunately, that means that this guy is going to be very, very slow. We have too many divisions over here. We just simply don't need this many to win this, I think. Four divisions is probably plenty. We'll take Brest, which is a port. Alright, there's all of Brittany returned to its former glory. You can't possibly have any organizations, so they'll just instantly die. And then these armies, as soon as one of them arrives there, they'll get reassigned. Italy just capitulated. Wow. And bam! Alright, we're in a pretty good spot then. They still control a lot of land down here. We're gonna have to go and, you know, they're in exile, so we've gotta take that back. But, France is back, baby! Alright, cool. I'm gonna take a break here. I'll see you again in the next episode. As always, thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.